Let's now add a semi-pitched roof to the building with wide overhangs supported by columns to create a south-facing veranda at the front. Open the gallery story from the project map of the navigator. Activate the roof tool in the toolbox and open its setting dialog. Display the geometry and positioning panel. Enter 1 meter for pivot line offset to home story. Make sure that the home story is set to gallery. Select the composite structure option. Select roof aluminum from the list. Select the single pane geometry method. Set perpendicular angle for the roof's edges. Enter 18 degrees for the roof angle. Display the floor plan and section panel of the dialog. Select the All Relevant Stories option for Show on Stories. Select the Projected with Overhead option for Floor Plan Display. Select Entire Element for Show Projection. Display the Model panel. Override the top surface with roof corrugated sheet mat, and override the edge surface as well as the bottom surface with wood pine-grained horizontal. Display the categories and properties panel. Select load-bearing element for structural function. Select exterior for position. And select roof for element classification. Make sure that the shell roof layer is selected. Click OK to apply all changes. Select the rectangular construction method from the info box. We will construct a pitched roof by defining its pivot line. Click on the internal corners of the masonry skin of the lower horizontal exterior wall. Define the direction of the slope by clicking above the previously defined pivot line with the eye-shaped cursor. Draw the perimeter of the roof using the external corners of the exterior wall. Select the roof. Click a corner hotspot of the selected roof and select the Offset All Edges option from the PET palette. Offset all edges of the roof up to the traced dashed lines, located 55 centimeters from the external surface of the wall. Activate the 3D window view in the pop-up navigator or from the tab bar. Pan and zoom in the 3D view as presented on the screen. You can see that the tops of the walls are not fully aligned to the roof. Now we'll trim them to the right height. Select the external walls by shift-clicking one of them. The walls are grouped, so if you have suspend groups off, which is a default setting in the standard toolbar, one selection will select all four exterior walls. Right-click and select Connect. Trim elements to roof or shell. Click anywhere on the roof. The empty roof icon turns black if the program finds a selectable roof element. Click the side of the walls you want to keep. The walls are now associatively trimmed to the roof. If you change the roof geometry or sloping angle, the walls will be updated automatically. Later on, you can review and manage the connections between the elements very easily. If you select an element which has connections, an icon appears on its surface. Click on the icon to get a list of current connections. You can highlight the intended elements as well as delete the connections together or one by one. Press Escape once to deselect all elements. We'd like to create a veranda at the back part of our building. To do so, we'll have to offset the roof and the bottom slab as well. We could perform these actions one by one, but instead we'll use a smart ARCHICAD feature called multi-element editing. First, select the roof and the external slab. Click on an edge of the slab. Select the offset edge option on the pet palette to modify both elements at the same step. Type 2.5 meters in the tracker to offset the edges of the roof and the slab in one step. Press Enter. Please note that multi-element editing works with all polygon-based elements except morph and shell. This way, you can easily cut holes through multiple slabs, roofs, or even meshes, move adjacent edges of elements, resize windows, and so on, in a single step. The elements can be of different types during editing. Press Escape once to deselect all elements.